It's Saturday, 4th August, and this is Top Stories by Rooster News. The Lok Sabha on Friday passed a bill establishing a national sports university in Manipur as part of a vision to enhance the country's standing in sports. The National Sports University Bill 2018, which sought to replace an ordinance promulgated on May 31st, was passed by voice vote. N.K. Premachandran of the RSP asked during the debate why an ordinance was required on such a routine legislation. He also said that a university had to be autonomous in character, something which the provisions of the bill did not suggest. Sports Minister Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore said that the legislation was introduced in the Lok Sabha in August 2017 but could not be passed. As the institution had already become functional and the budget session was a washout, the ordinance route was used to safeguard the future of the students. He said that the university would promote sports coaching and research at a cost of 524 crores. Hours after the Unique Identification Authority of India, or UIDAI, denied that it forced any smartphone manufacturer or telecom service provider to add a helpline number into people's contact lists, Google accepted that it had, in 2014, inadvertently coded the 112 distress number and the UIDAI number into its setup wizard for Android. This, in a way, put to end the controversy surrounding the mysterious entry of the UIDAI number in the contact list of many smartphone users around the country. Our internal review has revealed that in 2014, the then UIDAI helpline number and the 112 distress helpline number were inadvertently coded into the setup wizard of the Android release given to OEMs for use in India and has remained there since. Since the numbers get listed on a user's contact list, these get transferred accordingly to the contacts on any new device, a statement from Google said. Apologizing for any concern that this might have caused, the statement from a Google spokesperson said that it would like to assure everyone that this is not a situation of unauthorized access of their Android devices. District officials in Assam have begun work to delete the names of declared foreigners whose names had been included in the complete draft of the updated National Register of Citizens, or NRC, that was published on July 30th. In central Assam's Moregaon district, officials have identified some 200 people declared foreigners by various foreigners' tribunals or facing cases related to their doubtful citizenship. Assam has 100 such tribunals where people of suspect nationality are required to prove that they're Indians. The police in central Assam's Hojai district too have filed charge sheets against 91 people who had submitted fake documents while applying for NRC. The civil administration had filed 24 cases against such people when the NRC first draft was being published. Their papers were found to be forged, the district superintendent of police Ankur Jain told reporters. According to a statement issued by the Citizenship by Investment Unit, or CIU, of Antigua, SEBI found no evidence of wrongdoing against the fugitive diamond trader Mehul Choksi, who is co-accused in a 13,500 crore scam involving Punjab National Bank and other public sector banks in India. Mr. Choksi acquired citizenship of Antigua and Barbuda in November 2017. The SEBI has clarified that it has neither received any request from the CIU nor provided any information concerning Mr. Choksi or on the investigations against him. In the conduct of its due diligence, the CIU received documentation of two instances in which the Securities and Exchange Board of India, or SEBI, in 2014 and 2017 opened investigations on a corporate entity owned by Mr. Choksi, the CIU statement said. We requested updates on the status of the investigations and received documentary confirmation issued by the SEBI stating that in one case the matter had been satisfactorily closed and indicating in the other that there is not sufficient evidence to pursue the matter further, added the statement. This denial is significant since reports in February suggested that SEBI had reopened investigations in a matter wherein alleged that Mr. Choksi and his company Gitanjali Gems did not make certain mandatory disclosures and also submitted false information related to the quantum of shares pledged. An intruder was gunned down by security personnel on Saturday while he was trying to forcibly enter former Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, Farooq Abdullah's Jammu residence in a car. Omar Abdullah tweeted saying that details are awaited as security personnel carry out anti-sabotage checks and ascertain the background of the person. Jammu Senior Superintendent of Police Vivek Gupta told reporters, "The intruder breached the main gate and went inside. He had a scuffle with the duty officers there. A duty officer was also injured. After that, he entered the residence and there has been some sort of damage to the articles over there. Subsequently, he was shot dead." According to police, the intruder identified as Murfaz Shah was unarmed. He was a resident of Poonch district. The father of the intruder, who runs a gun factory in Bantalab in Jammu, questioned the security forces' action and asked why they didn't arrest him instead of killing him. We round up this newscast with fuel prices from key metros. In Delhi, petrol is sold for 76.54 rupees per litre and diesel for 68.06 rupees per litre. In Chennai, petrol is sold for 79.51 rupees per litre and diesel for 71.87 rupees per litre. In Kolkata, petrol is sold for 79.46 rupees per litre and diesel for 70.84 rupees per litre. In Mumbai, petrol is sold for 83.98 rupees per litre and diesel for 72.25 rupees per litre.